Vietnam's runaway energy bigwig faces second death sentence for embezzlement. Trinh Xuan Thanh allegedly agreed to undersell shares at PVB Lands project and accepted the buyer's $617,000 gift in return. Vietnam's top prosecutors on Thursday ratified charges against the runaway oil executive Trinh Xuan Thanh and seven others for embezzlement linked to his company's subsidiary. With this charge, Thanh, former board chairman and general director of PetroVietnam Construction, PVC, is facing the death penalty, the second to be charged against him this week. Dinh Manh Thang, former board chairman of Petro Song Da Trading and Investment JSC and brother of fallen political star Dinh La Thang, is also among those charged with embezzlement in this case. According to investigators, around the end of 2009 and early 2010, the state-owned oil giant PetroVietnam (PVN) had a policy to transfer all real estate subsidiaries to be managed by PVC, including PetroVietnam Power Land (PVB Land). During this time, Le Hoa Binh, chairman of 1/5 Construction and Service (JSC), wanted to buy the Nam Dan Plaza project, of which PVP Land held a 50.5% stake. Through a middleman, Binh signed a deposit contract to buy all 24 million shares from the five shareholders of Trans-Pacific JSC, the project's investor, for over 20,000 Vietnamese dongs, 90 cents per share. Thai Kieu Hong, deputy general director of Vietson Company, a shareholder of Trans-Pacific JSC, then asked Dinh Manh Thang to persuade Thanh to let PVP Land divest from the Nam Dan project. Thanh quickly agreed to the deal and instructed Dao Duy Bong, chairman of PVP Land, to arrange the transaction. With Thanh's approval, Bong sold PVP Land's 12 million shares at the Nam Dan project to Binh for only 34 million Vietnamese dongs per square meter, $1,250 per square yard, instead of the price of 52 million Vietnamese dongs per square meter, previously agreed in the deposit contract with Binh. This price difference resulted in PVP Land losing 49 billion Vietnamese dongs, according to investigators. Hong then told Binh to gift Thanh 14 billion Vietnamese dongs, while Phong received 10 billion Vietnamese dongs and Dinh Manh Thang received 5 billion Vietnamese dongs. The deal was, however, broken when police arrested Binh for a housing fraud case, in which he conned nearly 500 potential home buyers out of 790 billion Vietnamese dongs. The money Binh used to buy the Nam Dan project was also discovered to have come from the fraud. Following this arrest, Thanh, Phong and Dinh Manh Thang quickly returned all the gifts they had received, and only Phong was still linked to the case at the time. At the trial for the housing fraud in 2013, Binh was sentenced to life imprisonment, while Phong received a 6-year jail term. Earlier this week, the Supreme People's Procuracy also ratified charges against Thanh for his loss-making operations at PVC. In this case, he is facing death for property embezzlement and 20 years in jail for violating state regulations on economic management. The 51-year-old is set to stand trial in Hanoi in January for causing losses of around 3.2 trillion Vietnamese dongs, $147 million, when he was leading the construction unit between 2007 and 2013. Thanh caught media attention in June 2016, when he was a provincial deputy chairman, for driving a $230,000 Lexus with a government license plate in a country where the average annual income was around $2,200. The scandal caused uproar over the use of public money, prompting a probe into his political career and how he had been promoted. But by that time, he had already fled to Europe. The Ministry of Public Security issued an international arrest warrant for him in September 2016. He appeared on national television in early August this year saying he had turned himself in. But police have never elaborated on how he returned to Vietnam. Vietnam's energy and banking sectors have been at the center of the sweeping corruption crackdown spearheaded by Communist Party Chief Nguyen Phu Trong. Scores of people have been ensnared,